Kia ora Star Wars fans, welcome to Little H Kiwi Man collecting Star Wars figures. It's been a while since I've made a video. The reason is I haven't had much coming in the last few days, but that'll change today. It's Monday evening, New Zealand time, got home from work, one big package and one smaller package, so really looking forward to opening that up and getting into it. Some really cool stuff arriving from the vintage collection. Also, just a very quick reminder, this Saturday, Eastern Standard Time at 8 p.m, 1 p.m. New Zealand time, and I'm sorry UK viewers, 1 a.m. UK time, I'll be hosting my first ever live stream. It's called Legends of TVC, and I'm really excited to have my mates Chris from Bantha Skull and also Brett from Bantha Skull. Awesome guys, awesome website, so please come and join us for that chat. But anyway, let's just get on with what's in the box.
Today's haul consists of VC-100 Starkiller from the Expanded Universe, the photo reel there. We've got Sabine Wren from the Ahsoka Show, the deluxe figure. I'm really looking forward to cracking that open. And got the magnificent Return of the Jedi Jabba's Denizen set, which includes repack of Breeze, Tessic or Squidhead. We got Velkin Talzeri and Tayim Drengaran. So, picked up two of those. Hasbro Pulse America. So if you're in America and you're complaining about the price of those, I had to pay another $80 US to get those shipped over here. So an extra 10 bucks per figure. So $10 US per figure. So quite expensive, but really looking forward to cracking into those as well. Righty, let's have a look at Sabine Wren from the Ahsoka Show. So again, I'm really digging these deluxe boxes. Very nice image of her and the Loth Cat in her little workshop there. Sunburst sticker showing her with her helmet on there. Ahsoka logo, first one of these that I've seen. Nice little shot there with her blasters. And then on the back there, another shot, and then this classic image of all the bits and bobs that you get in this deluxe set. It's a nice cool image as well. Enough of the box. And as you come to expect with these deluxe sets, the figure comes the cardboard, and then you get a little wax baggie with all the accessories. Noisy. So far, all of these deluxe packs have just been from Disney Plus TV shows. So we've had The Book of Boba Fett, The Mandalorian, and Ahsoka. So nothing yet from any of the movies. And that's cool. I think that's maybe just coincidence, or maybe that's just a way they can get them out. And then one other thing I noticed is, in hand, the figure looks so much better than the figure on this packaging. So that was obviously an early prototype. So have a look at her face on there versus that. The figure is amazing. Right, and there she is with all her accessories. Now, if you've seen any other reviews, if you've watched Boss Bounties, or maybe you've seen the Bantha Skull review, you already know that it's an amazing figure and just the helmet is too big. But let's have a quick look at the figure. And the paint apps on this are awesome. Really amazing. That the likeness is really, really cool as well. All sorts of paint deco there. We've got the Rebel symbol on there. You've got that one. Bigger nerds than me know what that is. I don't know what that is, but it's really cool. She's got two holsters. She's got a little hole there for her lightsaber. She's got different paint apps on the shins. And I just had a quick look, and they look like decent-sized peg holes as well, so she's probably going to fit in a stand nicely. We'll test that out later. She's got all the articulation. I think one thing she might be lacking is hinges on the wrist. And there's been a bit of controversy lately. One is with this giant helmet. Let's have a look. Yep, it's pretty giant. It looks kind of ridiculous, but it's really nicely painted. And there's the movable rangefinder. Really nice helmet, just a bit too big, but we know why. Emily from the Hasbro team has said that the factory restrictions on the thickness of the plastic is a factor, and I think that's a factor in if they're not swappable heads, the helmets are too big. And I believe it also might be a factor in these small wrists don't have a hinge. So that seems to be the reason why. Otherwise, this is an outstanding figure. Just having a close-up look at all her accessories, you can see there she's got the two Westar blasters. One's got a little bit of blue paint on it, one's got a little bit of yellow, which is really cool. Extra detail there. Got this little paint gun that she uses in Rebels. I don't believe we saw it in the live action show, but that's all good. And the unlit hilt used to be Ezra's lightsaber. Now it's hers because she's made some modifications. Look at that. Awesome. Comes with a satchel. Just got some nice detail on it. It reminds me quite a bit of the satchels that come with the Razor Crest. And then we've got the little Lothcat. Meow! Meow! So Lothcat saved her life, didn't it? And it saved Ahsoka's life, I think, as well. So just really quickly, I wanted to show you this little hole that I just assumed was for the lightsaber hilt. And yes, the lightsaber hilt pegs in there perfectly. I was wondering, where am I going to put the paint gun? And then I noticed the paint gun has that. And I don't know whether it's supposed to be or not, but that can peg in there too, which is pretty handy. Especially if you want both of her blasters holstered, because I'm not exactly sure where the paint thing is meant to go. Yeah, she is in a fighting pose. I'm not exactly sure which blast is supposed to go in which hand. And then you can get the little satchel over her shoulder there. Yeah, she looks really cool. Again, that lightness is fantastic. And the good thing, even though the only downside to this figure is really this helmet being far too big. As you can see there, it looks kind of comical when it's on her head. But the good thing is, in the show, she barely wears the helmet at all. And so you can pose it with that awesome little head sculpt, which I think is fantastic and a really good likeness of the actor. Again, she's got fantastic articulation, and even though she doesn't have any hinges at the wrist, you can still get her doing the two-handed weapon grip or the thwig on the lightsaber, so it looks really cool. She's got that new style hip articulation, swivel at the thigh, decent knee articulation that goes over 90 degrees, rocker ankles, the usual articulation, and then she's got that those soft shoulder pads that they're doing nowadays, which means you can get the arm rotating all the way around, double barbell for the head, so you can get her doing different facial expressions, well, not facial expressions, but you know, move her head around. So yeah, very, very, very cool figure. This seems like a good opportunity to crack open my spare VC-222 Ahsoka. It's the same one it's from The Mandalorian, but it's the same one that's going to be initially repacked on the Ahsoka card. So let's get it out. So there we go, two outstanding figures. Really like this deluxe Sabine Wren. And that Ahsoka figure is fantastic as well. It's nice to open up another one of those. Two really, really good figures from two awesome characters from a really amazing show. I really enjoyed it. Three characters, because we've got our Lothcat. Meow! The life-saving Lothcat. Anyway, if you've made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I'm middle-aged Kiwi man collecting Star Wars figures. Ka kite, and I'll see you on another video.